Okay, so from what I'm hearing, after the whole IGN France fiasco, separate from America, if you guys don't know, a writer in IGN France actually said that the director of Stellar Blade didn't understand what didn't understand what a woman really looks like, and that she's a sex doll, and yada yada yada. Come to find out, he definitely knows what a woman looks like. I think Tacky, which is her friend in the game, is actually designed. Her face is the wife. It's his wife's, who actually works with him in the same studio, making the game. So he knows what a woman's body looks like. Plus, the model that was scanned for Eve's body is a real woman. Okay, and they say it's 1-to-1, so I guess it's her body. If you see her pictures, she definitely has a nice body. Nice bodies are achievable. Okay, you just gotta work at it. Problem is, a lot of people these days are not working at it. Just check Instagram. Okay? BBL City, baby. Now, so after IGN actually apologized about it and said, look, note also IGN and France are separate from us, my G. apparently, either the writer or the editor or somebody is still going off over there in France. And this has been translated. Okay? So let's check this out. He answered, yes, no problem. Go tell that to women who are hit, killed, denigrated, and who commit you know what because they cannot live up to the fictional standards expected by men. Are you serious? You think that... This is just ridiculous. So game characters like this, first of all, okay, so I guess this all was happening way back when sex symbols first started, okay? And I don't even know when they first started. So Marilyn Monroe's day, all of this was happening just because they just couldn't figure out a way to be as pretty as Marilyn Monroe. Right. How about this? I will give you this. Men and women both put unrealistic expectations on themselves these days. This video could go long depending on how deep I want to dive. I don't want to dive too deep. We put unrealistic expectations on ourselves. You know? And we can on each other. That's true. But we both do it. Okay? If you want to really get into the numbers of what is happening to young men out there too, okay? Because of women's unrealistic expectations of men. Have you heard of the 666? Huh? Calm down. A conspiracy theorist. Not going there. 6 figures, 6 feet, and 6 inches. Or 6 feet, 6 figures, and the six pack. Okay? Considering that most men are not 6 feet and above. Okay? Most men do not make 6 figures. Most men do not have a six pack, which would make that expectation, quote unquote, unrealistic. In a lot of people's eyes, right? When you look at the numbers, the majority of women are chasing after, I believe, it's like the top 17% of men. Top 17% of men. You know, what I found out about this, especially over here, because the whole metric system that we use, this over in other countries is not really a thing. They just want their man to be taller than them. It's a mental thing of being protected. But over here, because we use the metric, and 6 foot and this and that, it's that even number. Like, I'm 1 inch from 6 feet. Yeah, I'll probably do some spinal decompression. You know what I mean? And I'll be 6 feet. You get what I'm saying? But I'm 1 inch from that. Used to have a six pack. About to have it again. And I make a very good living. So I'll be in that top 17 or 15% again. But it's like, there's not a lot. Okay? Oh! And, yes, I fit the other category if you don't want the six-pack, ladies. I'm way above. Wait, don't nobody show this to Scarlo. I didn't mean it, babe. I didn't mean it to other women right now. I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? You know what's happening. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, so that's unrealistic for women, okay? We put it on each other and ourselves trying to look like other people. However, we need to digress here, okay? There have been beautiful people, men and women, throughout history that have had celebrity and have been used to sell everything to us. Everything from politics to food to gadgets to clothes, perfume, lingerie, shoes, everything. People like to look at good looking people. Okay? Women and men, listen. When I saw Chris Redfield tearing through zombies, when I saw Kratos kicking God ass, it did not make me feel bad about myself. You know what it did? See, because in my day, I had the comics, I had cartoons. I was a guy that loved the comics so much. And when I started working out, I said to myself, as I saw my body transforming, I was like, wow, as much as I admire these superheroes, I'm starting to look like them. Wow. Look at this. It was an inspiration for me. So I would say this to anyone that has ever felt a little down because you don't look as good as certain people in the public eye that use certain supplements and get surgeries that you don't have the money for and all this and that. Don't worry about it. Work on yourself. You become the best you, because when you become the best version of yourself, you truly learn to fall in love with who you are. It's taking yourself to the limits. You need to test your limits. And most of you don't. You got all these other stresses in life. And, you know, there's a whole lot of mental illness in the world right now. Way more than you would think. You truly can find it if you go over to Twitter. Go over to Twitter, type my name in. See how much mental illness is there. Go check out the profiles that are saying the stuff that they're saying. It's a ton of mental illness. These are people that do not function properly in society. They don't. And it's sad. It really is sad. A lot of the people belong literally in this asylum now, but they don't. Asylums don't exist anymore, from what I understand. They stopped. So I guess everybody's just medicated or off their meds. You get what I'm saying? It's really sad. But this is not good. Games, media, cartoons, movies, sitcoms, magazines, paintings, art, sculptures, just all these things that we see have revolved mainly around attractive people selling us something, or just it attracts the human eye. People look to create beautiful things. It is not going to make women go, oh. That's not going to happen. If it didn't happen when I saw, I kind of look like young Kratos, right? Anyway, but what I'm trying to say, this is really reaching. This is reaching. This is as much reaching as when someone says they don't like woke stuff, and then someone saying, "You've never had a girlfriend before." It's like, that's super reach. The problem is not that sexy design itself, except that it sucks compared to others. But hey, that doesn't matter. But the percentage of males who will only want this type of fictional body, it's not fictional. The body's not fictional. The body's not fictional. The body's not fictional. Okay? Let me tell you something. South Korea is the beauty capital of the world. I found this out through watching different stuff. They're the beauty capital of the world. So they are experts on beauty, on glass skin or dolphin skin, as you will. Okay? Which I've had from time to time. Okay? Pretty. They work out, they eat right, and they take care of their skin, their hair, their bodies. This is just people doing maintenance. They know how to do proper maintenance. You ever see the guy with the classic car that's gleaming more than a car that came out today, right off of the assembly line? That man or woman knows how to take care of that car, AKA your body. Become an enthusiast for your body and you will shine like that model. Or like your favorite whoever you want to look like, okay? Or be like. But like I said, you can aspire to that, but then turn that into becoming the ultimate version of yourself. Because you're never going to look exactly like whoever it is that you want to look like. You get what I'm saying? For several different factors. This doesn't make any sense. Obviously, we understand that this does not shock people who think. Yeah, okay. That women are objects who must obey and be beaten? What? 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 This is a big old piece of trash. Oh my God. This design makes us sigh and roll our eyes. Don't make me sigh. Well, it makes me sigh, not roll my eyes. And we laugh at anyone who needs it. Man or woman, but that's it. The certainly clashing remark in the text, which targets the entire creative process, not necessarily a specific designer or the game director. This is obvious to anyone who knows a little French. Only has this impact because a good portion of gamers have become too fragile to deal with being fed the patriarchy. Those writers are completely insane. That's what it says there. So, hey, it is what it is. I'm going to play this game and enjoy it. And most people, I believe, are going to play this game and enjoy it. Men and women. And I think females are going to be inspired by it. Because they're going to say, hey, yeah, she may be a little too sexy in this. However, this is a scan of a real woman. Okay? This scan of a real woman. This is achievable. This is grounded in reality. Her body is grounded in reality. This may be a fantastical game, but it's grounded in reality. This is achievable for many of us if we take care of ourselves. Okay? Post comments down below. Let me know what you all thought. If you enjoyed my thoughts on this, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe, and share.